good afternoon students. Today we are going to be discuss about perinatal care procedure. So what is the main purpose of perinatal care? We are doing perinatal care for the postnatal mother. For normally for a perinatal surgeries, they'll perform the perinatal care, that is different. For our obstetrics, midwifery and obstetrical nursing, perinatal care is different. So in that perinatal care procedure, they will always do outer to the inner. But now we are performing perinatal care inner to the outer. Okay. So for a postnatal mother, after a delivery, that is after 24 hours of time, we will start the perinatal care for the mother. Until the mother is discharged, perinatal care we have to be provided for the mother. And here, what is the main purpose of perinatal care means? While providing of perinatal care, we can reduce the infection for the mother, as well as we can promote the well-being for the mother. Understand? One is for promoting of well-being for the mother, for reducing of infection, and also any retained bits or cotyledons are there, we are going to be remove that one by using of this perinatal care. And also for assessing of involution process, we'll do this perinatal care procedure. Let us see what are the articles are there in the perinatal care procedure. So one is kidney tray with the paper bag for collecting of waste and dust, and as well as the used cotton swab also we are going to be throwing this paper bag. And betadine, instead of betadine we are using the Dettol solution. Now there is a need to be use the Dettol solution instead of betadine, because betadine is with the certain irritations for the perinatal care. So that's what we are using instead of that one Dettol solution. Now it is in a practice. Also inch tape is needed for checking of involution process, and surgical gloves while doing of this perinatal care procedure. There is a need of surgical gloves, and also there is a need of sterile pack with the cotton swabs, and bowl in a cotton swab also needed. And also a sterile kidney tray also we can use it. Then now let us come to the actual procedure. First, before we start a perinatal care, we have to check for involution process. By using of inch tape, we will check the involution process of uterus. So here, first for involution process, first identify the symphysis pubis. Place the inch tape over there and keep your index finger upon that, and remove the inch tape slowly. And below the ziphy sternum, you place your hands. Other hand you have to be placed below the ziphy sternum, and continuously with the palpation you identify the fundal upper border. So what is the main purpose of involution? What is the main purpose of this checking of symphysis fundal height means? For knowing of involution process as well as sub-involution process. I told you even in the previous classes also, sub-involution process is, if the involution process is retarded, we can say it as sub-involution. So what is the main reason for this sub-involution? Any retained bits or cotyledons inside of uterine cavity, or any infection. So due to that, there is a presence of sub-involution. So by this checking of involution process, we can identify the complications in early in postnatal mother. And after identification of fundal upper border, you tighten the inch tape and measure the symphysis fundal height here. So now according to my estimation, it is like 18 centimeters. And remove the inch tape, okay? Remove the inch tape and place in a tray again and start the perinatal care. So before you go for a hand wash, remove the sterile pack, outer parts, okay? And go for the hand wash. And after the hand wash, wear the surgical gloves. So we are going to start the perinatal care. We remove the sterile pack and hand washing is needed. And after wearing of surgical gloves, start the perinatal care. And in this sterile pack, cotton swabs are there, 8 to 9 cotton swabs. Count it and keep it, 8 cotton swabs. And here we are using the betadine Dettol solution, 10%, and with the pouring of water. And after pouring of this Dettol solution, we'll start the perinatal care. Before we start this one, remove the previous pad and observe the previous pad for any discharges or any active bleeding. And also you observe lochia rubra is present or any other lochia color like serosa or alba is present or not. You examine the lochia color, and also you see the ador. So whether it is a fishy odor, if it is a normal one in a lochia form, if it is a abnormal odor like a foul smell is present, that is indicating there is a presence of infection for the mother. So examine even for the discharge as well as even odor, and also look the episiotomy site also, whether any active bleeding is there in the episiotomy site, any discharge, abnormal bruising or swelling is there in the episiotomy site, you have to be see. And also sutures are whether the healing process is started or not, any wound distance is present or not, you are going to be examined for the episiotomy site. And after that, start the perinatal care procedure. Take one cotton swab and squeeze it properly. Dettol solution is there, so that's what, squeeze it properly. And it should not be, this perineal area should not be more wet. So that's what, squeeze the cotton swab properly. And while starting of perineal care, always center to the outer. So first you are going to be clean the part of Mons pubis. This is the part of Mons pubis. Always start from the center to the outer. So here I am starting. So you just see, with the, by using of cotton swab, center to the outer you are giving the stroke, and there is a no gap between the, there is a no gap between the two spaces also. Clean it as continuously. There should be a no gap between the cleaning part also and the other part also, opposite part also. Turn your artery forceps and clean the remaining half of the part of Mons pubis. Okay, throw this cotton swab and take the other cotton swab. And here the next stroke is, second one is from center the, to the outer, that is from the clitoris to the down, one stroke we will give continuously. Center to the outer, one stroke we will give. So if it is needed extra discharge is there, you are going to be clean it again. You turn your artery forceps and give central stroke from upper to the down until the forceps area, and throw the cotton swab and take the other cotton swab, and with your other hand separate the labia majora and start cleaning of labia minora. So always from the forest part to the nearest part. So clean the forest part from center to the down in a one stroke, and turn your artery forceps and clean the remaining half of the part of labia minora nearest part. Okay, and throw the cotton swab and take another cotton swab, and this is for labia majora. So from center to the outer always, and from upper to the down you are cleaning continuously. You have to be clean the labia majora also, and turn your artery forceps and clean the remaining part of labia majora always, center to the down in part. You can observe this one, continuously we are cleaning, there is no gap in between the part, and clean it properly, and always from upper to the down you have to be clean. And take the other cotton swab, clean the episiotomy site. Sometimes we can use the gauze piece also if the suture site is there, no? So that's what, cotton swab if anything sticky or anything. So you can use even instead of this one, gauze piece also. Otherwise, cotton swab also you can use it. Center to the outer, one stroke you will give it for episiotomy site. If any extra discharge is there, you turn the artery forceps and clean it from center to the outer and throw the cotton swab. Okay. The next one is anal orifice. The anal orifice will clean it as round in clock in manner. Round in clock in manner, you are going to be clean the anal orifice. Then throw the cotton swab. And next cotton swab is for lateral aspects of thigh. Okay, lateral aspects of thigh. So see here, from center to the outer, first forest part. So clean like this, from center to the outer. And continuously you have to be clean, there should be no other gap. We already cleaned this all the part also, even down part also you will clean it like this. And turn your artery forceps and clean the remaining half of the part of other side of this lateral aspects of thigh. Then after cleaning this part, okay, apply the ointment over the episiotomy site. Apply the ointment and apply even infrared light. Before applying of ointment itself, you can apply the infrared light also, because episiotomy site is with the full of pain. So for reducing of this pain, we'll ask the mother to be go for proper hot water baths after the delivery. And even if it is necessary, like the mother can be used a certain cold applications also, or hot applications also she can use it. And the one way, while giving of perineal care, we will apply even infrared light also. Like with a distance of 20 centimeters, we will start the infrared light. For a 10 to 15 minutes of time, we will give the infrared light. And after applying of infrared light, the pain will be little, it will be reduces for the mother. And we will apply the pad for the mother. So we'll secure the pad in front. Okay. And properly we will secure it. And we will turn the mother. Yes. Okay. After securing of pad in front, We'll ask the mother to be turned at a back. We'll clean the back of buttocks also. So even while cleaning of back of buttocks also, always center to the outer we'll follow. Continuously we'll clean it. Okay. Like this, the strokes we'll give always from center to the outer. And turn the artery forces and clean the remaining half of the part of buttocks. And even this pad, we'll secure for the mother properly even at a back. Okay. This is about the perinatal care procedure. This is about perinatal care procedure. Just expose here. This is perinatal care procedure, ma. So, for all the postnatal mother, it is a necessary perinatal care we have to be provided at least after the delivery. The mother will stay in the hospital for a 3 days of time. You have to be provide this perinatal care. By providing of perinatal care, you can reduce the infection for the mother and you can decrease even puerperal sepsis cases, puerperal shock cases. Sepsis cases, infection cases, you can reduce and we can promote the well-being of mother as well as baby also. And involution process also will be takes properly and there won't be any further infections for the mother. And here if you observe, the perinatal care procedure is with the 8 to 9 cotton swabs. Okay, one stroke is, one cotton swab is remaining here. It's a 8 to 9 cotton swabs we are going to be using for the perinatal care procedure. If any part is with the extra discharge, we are going to be using one more cotton swab in that extra discharge place. Okay, so this is the perinatal care. As a nurses, as a midwife, you have to be replace the articles. You have to be right about this perinatal care procedure in nurses column, nursing care column, and you will mention so whether any infection is there, what about the episiotomy site, what about the lochia, and what about the symphysis fundal height. You need to be mentioned these all the aspects. Thank you.